that you will live on. But I heard his voice say, I heard his voice say, here's a pain, it is not your portion. Failure, it is not your portion. Sickness.
Throughout generations, television ministry. God bless you. My name is Evangelist Rochelle McClam Melton, host. Elder Diamond McClam is the co-host, and we came to give you good news on today, Saturday, every Saturday from 3:30 to 4 o'clock p.m. on Kingdom Purpose Television. God is good. We don't own the right to that music. So that song is by Jekyll Carr, My Portion. God told us to tell you that your portion is not sickness, it's not death, it's not being able to be overcome by the enemy. But he said he wants to fill our cup on today. And that's what the message is. Hallelujah. He woke me up in my spirit and said, fill my cup, Lord. Anybody out there need their cup filled on today, this afternoon, or whenever you're going to pull up this telecast? Fill my cup. I know it's some voids in our lives, oh God, that we need filling. I don't want any area of my life not filled with God. Amen. Because the enemy can just take a little hole. If he gets a little opening, he can come in with different things that you don't want to be in your mind, you don't want to be in your heart, you don't want to be in your spirit. But ask God to fill your cup. Fill it up, Lord. Not just the natural cup, but the spiritual cup. Fill my cup, Lord. Somebody say it on today. I hear him saying, fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench this thirst in my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. And we don't own the rights to this zone. Amen. But we thank God, because he has put this in our spirit on today, and he wants us to surrender. He wants us to worship him. He wants us to give it up. Amen. He wants to fill every void, everything in our life that's not like him, that's empty, that's thirsting for him.
Fill my cup, Lord. I lift it up, Lord.
Take your time to surrender to God.
Come and quench this thirsting in my soul. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me. Just raise our hands and just say it. Fill my cup, Lord.
Everybody.
I lift it up, Lord. Come and quench. Come and quench this thirsting in my soul. Bread of heaven. Singing. Fill my cup, fill it up, and make me whole. I need say it, Zion.
Thank you.
Can we just raise it up, Zion, everybody? I need the Lord. I need thee.
Thank you. Yes, God. Touch, Lord. Touch everyone that's listening on today, oh God. Touch, oh God. And as that song was, hallelujah, was playing, the Lord said, make me whole. Think of somebody, hallelujah, not only yourself. And he go ahead and he write a list, thank you, Lord, of people that need touching, hallelujah, the people that need that. It comes to your mind, hallelujah. This is throughout generations, amen, people in your family, people, hallelujah, that you know, that need God's touch on today. Amen. Write them down. Hallelujah. Get them in your mind as you pray. Hallelujah. As you ask, surrender to God on today and ask him to touch and to make whole, oh God. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Psalms 42 said, as the deer panteth after the water brook, so panteth my soul after thee, O Lord. Thirsty. Anybody out there thirsty for the God on today? Anybody know, hallelujah, that you need God to do a new thing in your life? Amen. We thank you, Lord. We thank you as the deer. Hallelujah. Panteth after the water brook. So panteth my soul after thee, O Lord. Verse 2 says, my soul thirsteth for God. Hallelujah. For the living God. When shall I come and appear before God? My tears have been my meat day and night, while they continually say unto me, where is thy God? Thank you, Jesus. When I remember these things, I pour out my soul in me. For I have gone with the multitude. I went with them to the house of God, with the voice of joy and praise, with the multitude that kept holy day. Why art thou cast down, O my soul? Thank you, Jesus. And why art thou disquieted in me? Hope thou in God, for I shall yet praise him, hallelujah, for the help of his countenance. Oh my God, my soul is cast down within me. Therefore will I remember thee from the land of Jordan and of the Hermonius, from the hill of Massar. Deep calleth unto deep at the noise of thy water parts, and all thy waves and thy billows are gone over me. Let the Lord will command his loving kindness in the daytime, and in the night his song shall be with me, and my prayer unto the God of my life. So many things are going on in the world. Hallelujah, you're searching and you're thirsting, hallelujah, and you're looking for God, oh God. You're looking for something, but you don't know. You're looking in all the wrong places sometimes. But God is the one, hallelujah. The Bible tells us shall I lift up my eyes to the hills, from which cometh my help. My help cometh from thee, O Lord. Hallelujah. Speak, Lord. My soul thirsteth. Hallelujah. My heart. Hallelujah. Cry out for the living God. Amen. Hallelujah. Why art thou cast down? Hallelujah. Oh, my soul. Anybody got hope in God on today? Anybody know that God will do it? Amen. That God will do it. Amen. We thank you. Hallelujah. He will fill those voids. He will continually, hallelujah, to pour out his spirit upon us as we seek him and as we love him. Amen. He will continue to fill us up, oh God. Because each day, hallelujah, takes some things away from us. We give out so much. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But God wants to refill us with his presence. He wants to refill us with his joy. He wants to refill us, oh God, and to revive us again. Hallelujah. Say, Lord, revive me again. Hallelujah. I want you to do it again, oh God. In the name of Jesus, do it one more time. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for doing it. We believe you, God. Hallelujah. That you're going to refill us. You're going to bring the people back to the place that you would have for us to be, oh God. Hallelujah. On our knees, laying prostrate. Hallelujah. Out to you, oh God. Hallelujah. Thirsting for you. Longing for you. Turn off the Facebook. Hallelujah. Sometimes turn off the radio. Sometimes even turn off the television. But if you turn on the television and the radio, get into God's presence. Get into the worship. Hallelujah. Put you some worship music on. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Put you on some preachers, oh God. Hallelujah. And just spend that quiet time with God. Thank you, Lord. He's drawing you. Hallelujah. He said you can't come unless he draw you. But he's drawing you on the day. He's drawing you. He's hungry. He's hallelujah. He said, I'm here. Thank you, Lord. To fill every void. To fill everything in your life that you're looking for. I got it. Hallelujah. If you call on Jesus, we sing a song in the Church of God in Christ. If you call on Jesus, he will answer your prayer. He will answer if you call him. All you got to do is open up your mouth, open up your heart, hallelujah, and surrender to God. Touch me, oh God. Touch my mind. Hallelujah. We were talking about on Bible class on last night. Elder Diamond, Elder McClain was talking. Our co-host was talking about the mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It all starts in the mind. It all starts with a choice. Hallelujah. You have a choice. You do have a choice. The enemy sometimes doesn't want you to think that you have a choice, that you have a decision. But hallelujah. But hallelujah. Make a choice, a conscious choice on today to let God take over. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Stop trying to be in control of your life. Hallelujah. Because hallelujah, where has it gotten you? Amen. Hallelujah. Still in the same place over and over. Thank you, Lord. Over and over again. You ask for God to do something at the, you know, over 1 year, and you look and you say, he going to do it this year. I'm going to do it. I'm going to do it this year. Hallelujah. But the Lord said it's no more I. It's the Christ that lives down inside of us. Amen. And the life that we now live, we don't live it through. Hallelujah. We live it through God. We can't do it on our own, but we have to surrender to him. And we have to let other people know that what you're looking for, when they complain to you, when they call you, hallelujah, and ask you and tell you different things, tell them to pray. Say, let's stop and pray. Instead of talking so much, let's just pray. Let's pray. Hallelujah. You let them get it out. Hallelujah. Because they're looking and they're thirsting, hallelujah, for something. Hallelujah. They're asking you, hallelujah, and they're asking, really seeking God. Hallelujah. Be that voice, hallelujah, for God. Be the voice for God. Let them see, hallelujah, and let them know that it is, we're going to take it to God in prayer. Amen. We're going to let God know, hallelujah, that we surrender to him and that we love him and that we know our only hope in him. And amen, we're just going to play the next song. Amen. Good God, hallelujah, by Jonathan Nelson, I believe it is. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The next song, whatever it is, amen. Thank you, Jesus. Jonathan McRose, withholding nothing. Amen. Just don't withhold, don't hold back anything. Everything. Don't only write to the spirit. God.
Withholding nothing.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you for your sweet spirit.
Withholding nothing.
Thank you, every shackle.
Lord, I surrender all to you.
Ministry, television ministry. I'm Evangelist Rochelle McClam Melton, the host, and Elder Diamond McClam is the co-host. And we want our generations, hallelujah, to be able to see us, amen, surrender to God. A lot of times your generation see you do this and see you do that. It makes a difference in their life. The life that you live before them, amen, the life that they see, we can tell them to do this and to do that and don't do that. But if they see us, hallelujah, as their father or as their mother or as their aunt, their grandmother doing different things, they will say, well, my grandmother did it, my father did it, my mother did it. But we don't want to withhold anything. We're not only just living this life for ourselves, but we're living, say, present your body a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And it will, hallelujah, go from one generation to the other. Train up a child in the way that they should go, and when he is old, they will not depart from the training. Plant those seeds, hallelujah. Let them know when they need something, hallelujah, when they're looking for something, when they're, hallelujah, when their back's up against the wall. Thank you, Lord. When the enemy come in like a flood, let them know that the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standing against the enemy. Amen. We thank you. Hallelujah. It said, Hebrews 4:12 says, for the word of God is quick and it is powerful and it is sharper than any two-edged sword. it will get down unto the piercing, even unto sunder of soul and spirit, and the joints and the marrow, and is a discerner of the thoughts and the intents of the heart. God can take away, hallelujah, like we say in the church, hallelujah, can clean, take out everything that's not like him. Ask him on today to purge you, hallelujah, to deliver you, to set you free from every bondage, from every trial, every tribulation, every hurt, every pain. He can do it. He can do it. There is nothing too hard for God. Hallelujah. Nothing is impossible with God. He is a great God. He's a loving God. Hallelujah. And he wants good for us. Our scripture that we use for throughout generations is Jeremiah 29:11. I know the thoughts that I have toward you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of good and not evil, to bring you to that expected end. And that expected end here is peace and joy and love. Doesn't mean that we're not going to go through things, but he's going to carry us. Amen. He's going to, hallelujah, sustain us. He's going to keep us, hallelujah, if we cast all our cares on him, because he cares for us. And we thank God for carrying us. We thank God for sending his son Jesus to die on the cross for us, because, hallelujah, his mercy is great. And we, man, please tune us back in as we end up with, great is thy mercy toward me. God is merciful. Hallelujah, by Donnie McClurkin. We don't own the rights to this song. But Lord, Father, in the name of Jesus, have mercy, O God, on us, O God. And continue to fill us up, O God. Continue to give us, to lean out and to stretch out on you, O God. Hallelujah, to ask you to touch us and to make us whole from the top of our head, oh God, to the sole of our feet. We believe you, God, for everything. Look on our families, look on our loved ones, look on the people, oh God, that wants you, that needs you, oh God. Hallelujah, draw and touch and have mercy. In the name of Jesus, tune us back in on next Saturday. This is Through Our Generations Ministries, 3:30 to 4 o'clock p.m. on Kingdom Purpose Television. God bless you. We love you.
It is your grace. Help me stand for you.